This memorial dedicated to Rebecca Thompson is where police are saying she was gunned down in front of her infant child. This sign behind me has had several faces since it was first built more than 50 years ago. And when it was threatened to be torn down, many community members joined together. Painters of all ages are welcome to participate in this event, but it can be a bit messy, so it's encouraged to dress appropriately. A homicide investigation has recently been opened after the death of Mary Nolan. While the sign is a big attraction point to the new park, this mural by Ian Brownlee is also a unique addition. All of this is an effort to make this area of downtown Johnson City a destination point. A Rock and Roll Hall of Famer is coming here to the Paramount for a special concert just in time for Independence Day, where the Paramount will be launching its new half-price special for active military and vets. The fine for littering is $50, and that's why the Washington County Sheriff's Office is initiating its new program, Tarp It or Ticket. The Trash Barrel Paint-In is one of FunFest's most popular kickoff events. It encourages others to keep Kingsport clean in a fun and colorful way. A recent homicide investigation has been opened up after the death of Mary Nolan. She was found severely beaten in her home right down this road in Carter County. I came out here today to talk to some neighbors about their concerns and her family on how they're handling her death. The Gray Fossil Site predates the Ice Age, and paleontologists from all over the Southeast are coming here for a special conference to take a deeper look at the history of our local environment. Our region's real estate prices are at a 9-year high, and this particular neighborhood in Kingsport is thriving with more than 30 sales a year. But low inventory across the board is causing some concern for realtors and buyers. Our guest for this program is a TV reporter whose beat includes Washington, D.C. and the halls of Congress. She provides local affiliate reporters for over 150 stations and also appears on MSNBC. How do political campaigns necessarily go into that social aspect of marketing? How do they pick Facebook over Twitter or and so forth?
They're leading with who they want to have a conversation with.
I spoke with domestic violence survivor and she shared her experience. At the request of the guest, her identity and voice has been altered.
I try to put it in the back of my mind. I prayed to God that I'd get through it. But I knew after it got so bad, I knew I was probably not going to make it unless I'd put my foot down.
This sign behind me has had several faces since it was first built more than 50 years ago. And when it was threatened to be torn down, many community members joined together to help with a new fundraising project. And now we find out how their efforts are helping to create a new face for downtown Johnson City. The campaign achieving landmark status has been an $88,000 project so far. Fundraisers have reached this goal through various pledges and other donations, but now they're needing more.
With every project, there's been additional expenses, and so at this point, our goal is to raise another $3,000 to $5,000 just to cover those unexpected expenses.
The sign will be located in King Commons Park once both are complete. The park is the third phase of Johnson City's stormwater management project.
This space will be an environmentally educational space. We're going to have pollinator gardens. We have opened up two creeks. We'll have some solar sidewalks in here, so in the evening there'll be some really unique things that you want to come down and visit.
All of this is a part of the downtown restoration process. While the sign is a big attraction point to the new park, this mural by Ian Brownlee is also a unique addition. All of this is an effort to make this area of downtown Johnson City a destination point. Diana Kantler also explained what the city hopes the landmark sign will bring to the community.
Once it's lit, people will really see how visible it's going to be from a lot of areas downtown and how it really will be the iconic image that Johnson City will be known for.
The sign will be finished in 2 weeks, followed by King Commons in September. Getting the facts right in Johnson City, Abby Hathorn, News 5, WCYB. The Trash Barrel Paint-In is one of FunFest's most popular kickoff events. It encourages others to keep Kingsport clean in a fun and colorful way. A 32-year-old tradition of Fun Fest, the barrel paint-in is an all-around eco-friendly project.
These barrels are actually donated by Domtar, so it's just a great big happy green cycle because we're keeping the barrels out of the landfill. We're painting them, repurposing them.
For just $5, it's fun and easy for everyone. This year, more than 400 people came out to participate.
It's just a really good way to get folks out. As you can see, we've got families with, you know, children. I've got grandparents out here. It's folks of all ages coming out.
It doesn't matter if you're a budding Picasso.
It'll be me.
Or an experienced artist.
We love to paint, and we're a really artistic family anyway, so anything that will get us out of the house and around people and to be able to show our ability a little bit.
It's all about fun and keeping the streets of Kingsport clean.
Fun Fest has a long-standing tradition of being a litter-free festival as much as possible, and that is made possible by the fact that you pretty much can't walk any direction in, you know, 5-6 feet and you're going to run into a trash barrel.
The paint-in promotes recycling and learning how to keep Kingsport beautiful, not only during Fun Fest, but other events throughout the year.
Painters of all ages are welcome to participate in this event, but it can be a bit messy, so it's encouraged to dress appropriately. Getting the facts right in Kingsport, I'm Abby Hathorn with News 5 WCYB.